Let's now consider an example of a specific shock, terms of trade shock. We'll assume a drop in commodity prices and define a country as a commodity exporter with a pegged exchange rate regime. Let's call this country A. Imagine this country experienced a significant drop in its export price. Economic growth slowed down and the output is estimated to be below potential, while currency is assessed to be overvalued and there is a large drop in current account balance. The exchange rate is pegged to the United States dollar. There are no capital controls. What are the policy options for country A to get back to internal and/or external balance? The answer depends on whether this shock is transitory or permanent. In reality, it can be difficult to know in advance. If transitory and commodity prices are expected to recover, expansionary fiscal policy would be generally appropriate to support economic activity. The central bank can use reserves to support the national currency. Achieving external balance will require other measures, like internal devaluation, through wages, for example, to help competitiveness. If the shock is expected to be persistent or permanent, there can be two options for policy response. Option one would be to help the economy adjust through the exchange rate. If exchange rate is overvalued, devaluation will help to bring the real exchange rate closer to equilibrium and help the current account balance. To help support aggregate demand, country A can use accommodative fiscal policy or keep it neutral. Adjusting through the exchange rate would be used in case of low level of reserves when keeping the peg through continuous interventions might become too expensive and undermine external buffers. Another important consideration is existing fiscal vulnerabilities. A negative terms of trade shock for commodity exporter will also affect fiscal position and might require fiscal consolidation to adjust to lower fiscal revenue. What about a second option? Preserving a peg can continue to provide a helpful nominal anchor for policymakers, especially in countries that are highly undiversified. However, when country faces prolonged fiscal and external deficits, policy adjustment must come from fiscal consolidation measures. Fiscal adjustment in this situation might be rapid or gradual. This will depend on the existing fiscal and external buffers of a country, such as assets in the sovereign wealth fund or international reserves. If such buffers are limited, this might warrant a rapid adjustment, which could be painful for the economy in the short run, but important to move to equilibrium in a longer run. An example of a country that kept the peg and opted for gradual fiscal consolidation is Saudi Arabia. Prior to 2014, Saudi Arabia's sustained fiscal and external surpluses helped strengthen macroeconomic stability and rebuild policy buffers. Fiscal spending increased steadily for more than a decade, supported by high oil prices and oil revenues. Mindful of fiscal risks from oil price fluctuations, the government paid off most of its debt and built up large financial assets. Oil prices have fallen by close to 50% since mid-2014. Decline in oil prices has substantially lowered export and fiscal revenues, resulting in a fiscal deficit and narrowing current account surplus in 2014. Fiscal deficit widened significantly in 2015, despite a sizable reduction in spending. The exchange rate peg has provided monetary policy credibility and has helped deliver low inflation. At the same time, the country opted for gradual fiscal consolidation to adjust to lower fiscal revenue. To recap, Swan Diagram presents a simple analytical tool that can help streamline analysis of macroeconomic policy and show policy options, expenditure changing or expenditure switching, to achieve internal and external balance.